Because of all that is going on, I'm afraid to return phone calls or use my email. Therefore, I recorded this video to let all of you know that I have been receiving your messages.
In the one-minute YouTube video titled Dr. Conrad Murray Thanks Supporters, Michael Jackson's personal physician makes only a vague reference to the manslaughter investigation now focused on him.
I have done all I could do. I told the truth, and I have faith the truth will prevail.
But police sources tell NBC News they have more questions for Dr. Murray and haven't been able to schedule a third interview with him. They've already searched his luxury home, offices, storage units, and the pharmacy he used. The sources say he administered the anesthetic propofol to Jackson on the day he died. His lawyer maintains Dr. Murray did nothing wrong, but the video doesn't address any of that.
I want to thank all of my patients and friends who have sent such kind emails, letters, and messages to let me know of your support and prayers for me and my family. Your messages give me strength and courage and keep me going. They mean the world to me.
Dr. Murray gets to get out there and make a statement without being cross-examined by prosecutors or asked any probing questions by pesky journalists. He just gets to float his side of the story without being challenged.
Please, don't worry. As long as I keep God in my heart and you in my life, I will be fine.
As Dr. Murray posted his video online, the Jackson family announced plans for Michael's funeral. After all the talk of a Neverland burial, it won't happen. Instead, he'll be laid to rest here at Forest Lawn Cemetery, 15 minutes from Hollywood in Glendale, California. The service will take place on what would have been Jackson's 51st birthday, Saturday, August 29th. Jackson's body will be placed inside a mausoleum.
Where Michael's going to be buried now is highly secure and remote. There are other big-name movie stars there, and it's not the kind of place that people are going to be able to visit.